Imagine waiting about 17 years for a certain income. As a parent, you've done everything that you can and made many sacrifices for this day to arrive. What day is that? Graduation day. All over the city, high school seniors and their parents are preparing for a certain occasion that many believe that it's a significant cost to adulthood. But for whatever reason, your son or daughter is not welcome across the stage. Think about that for a second. For 17 years, you've done everything you could to get your child through, and you graduate to celebrate that day, but they're not welcome across the stage. Better yet, how about having to deal with the burden of building your son or daughter out of jail? Or wasting their lives slowly away because they're abusing alcohol or drugs. As a parent, would you have to ask yourself, is there something more that I could have done? Where did I go wrong? There are many influences out there that are ready to take advantage of our children if we don't act now as parents. Today, we'll discuss why it's important for us to be good parents and have an active role in our children's lives. Second, we'll identify some of the negative influences that may be obstacles in our way to becoming successful. Third, and finally, we'll discuss what we can do to take action against those negative influences. Let's begin by answering the question, why is it important to be good parents? Many of us don't realize how important the influence that we have on our children. If we're doing good things, instead of good examples like being polite, being respectful of others, and maintaining good health, more likely they're going to fall suit. On the flip side of that, we're out there abusing drugs, alcohol, using profanity, and making negative comments about other people. In turn, they're going to do that because we're setting a bad example. We all want our children to grow up in life and be successful and lead good lives and do things that they should do. As parents, we owe to our children to help them prepare for life's challenges in order for them to avoid obstacles and lessons learned that we went through so they don't have to. We do not take ownership of our responsibilities as parents. We're going to let allow someone else to do it. There are many influences out there that await our children if we don't take different courses of action now. Television is one of them, right? It's not too long, it won't be too long before your child flips to a channel and they're watching something that is not suitable for the viewing. It's sad to say, but it is highly possible that your child could lose their innocence just by watching TV. It could be that they're watching something violent or something pertaining to sex. Also sitting in front of the TV, it doesn't, for lots of hours, it doesn't go well for maintaining good physical fitness and health. Right? Another one would be celebrities. Okay? In many, many situations, celebrities have more influences on children than teachers and parents. Right? Athletes, actors, pop singers, what have you, they're idolized by starstruck youngsters. And it's easy for your young one to fall prey to them. Last but not least, it can be their friends. Alright, building a team here is just like all of us. We want to be cool. Alright, that's important, especially when you're among your peers. But if your child is hanging around the wrong group of people, it can be very challenging for you as a parent. Alright, having the wrong group of friends could lead to having sex too early, using drugs, or alcohol. What are some things that we can do to become better parents? One way is to get the advice from someone else, your grandparents, your parents, or see from another different professional, stuff like that. Right? Unfortunately, children don't come with directions on how to raise them. Right? There's no such thing as a perfect parent or a perfect child. Here are some of the actions that we can take against some of the negative influences of our children when they come face to face. One, spend more time with them. Right? The one thing that our children want most from us is our time. That's what they want most from us. What our kids want most is their attention. It would be a good idea to spend more time talking to them also. It wouldn't hurt to read to them, go for a walk, do some chores, help them with their homework. Right? The second thing you can do is be a good listener. It's important to let your child know that what they have to say is important. Right? And last of many is to encourage praise. Alright, let me give you an example. my oldest son, Marcus Jr., he was about 6 years old, and he was playing Pee Wee League basketball. I remember sitting in the stands, gym's back, and my son, on the last four possessions, this dude went down there and jacked off, shot all the shots. One of them was a hog break, one of them missed a goal air ball. It was something to watch, especially being a father in that stand, in the bleachers that day. But afterwards, we went to McDonald's, and he's, you know, they had the team that win the game. And he said, "Dad, you know, how did I do? How did I do?" Now, knowing that he went out there and really jacked it up, you know what I told him? I said, "Hey, man, just keep working at it. You'll eventually get to the rim and you'll make it." And guess what? My son is 19 now, and he is on a full scholarship playing basketball for a Division I school. Just for that girl. Now, maybe LeBron James, Miley Cyrus, you know, Justin Bieber, and Lil Wayne are all good people, I'm sure. But for me, I would much rather raise my child and let them do it. In closing, we've discussed why it's important for us to be good parents. We've talked about some of the negative influences, and we've also covered some of the actions that we can take against those negative influences. Okay? Everything that we've covered today can be summed up in one word: love.